At 5:10 this morning, let's take a pretty nice picture as you take a live look out through our Lee Circle camera at the beautiful Crescent City Connection Bridge. But guess what? That picture will soon change. Jake LA's got your weather, and we've got your traffic here at WDSU every 10 minutes. And with that said, Jay, yes. More rain is coming our way.
More rain
there is
in the forecast.
There was a huge storm. It was really interesting yesterday. Mark Drago, our director, and some of the folks in the back were showing a really cool picture of a cloud just moving over the city. I mean, you could actually see this cloud dumping rain across parts of Metairie and parts of Lakeview.
Very you see the rain picture. Shaft.
Yeah.
Yeah, and that's going to be the case again today. We've got an upper-level system that's going to, a mid-level system that's going to move through here, and that's going to be combined with a very tropical air mass. When we say a tropical air mass, that means it has a capability or it's holding a lot of water. So as a result, the possibility of a lot of rainfall coming down in a short amount of time does exist. Let's have a look at the water vapor satellite imagery. Here's what's going on. We're kind of stuck in between an area of high pressure back off toward the northwest and an area of low pressure back off toward the southeast. So high pressure situated here, right? And then low pressure situated back here. We're kind of caught right in between right here. And that's why we're developing this little mid-level feature. It's going to be a mid-level trough that's going to really enhance our rain chances and combine with this very, very moist air mass. As a result, flash flood watch is in effect from 8 a.m. to 7 p.m. You can see the map. This is going to encompass the entire viewing area. So all of southeast Louisiana and southern Mississippi, you are going to be under the gun. Few rainfall totals from yesterday. We set a record at the New Orleans International Airport. Over two-thirds of an inch of rain there. Only 4/100ths in Slidell. Lakefront had just over a third of an inch, and Gulfport came in with about a quarter of an inch. So everyone saw some rainfall, some a little bit more than others. Out in the tropics real quick, still watching this tropical wave. Now at about a 10% chance, which is a low chance of this becoming tropical over the next couple of days. This will continue moving to the west at about 15 miles per hour. All the models keep it in the extreme southern Gulf of Mexico. Development is going to be difficult at this point. 70s right now on the map, 70s to 80s for the most part. Your forecast model is showing we're going to move right through this. We've got some rain toward the south by lunchtime. Notice this little mid-level feature. Actually, this is a surface low that will develop. You can kind of make out that rotation. We'll get a break overnight tonight, but by tomorrow morning, look at all the rainfall toward the west, and that will overspread us by tomorrow, working in about a 70% chance of rain then, which is going to be what we're going to have for today. Highs are going to be cooler, though, because of the rain, cooled air, and the clouds. We'll keep it in the 80s to near 90 overnight tonight and into tomorrow. We'll have 70s for the most part. A few showers will probably develop. We'll go clear to partly cloudy. It'll be mild, still a little on the muggy side. And your 7-day exact cast, again, showing with those elevated rain chances. Today through Thursday, highs will only reach the upper 80s. Then we'll drop your rain chances back down during the weekend. But notice how your temperatures move into the lower 90s. There's your look at weather. Let's turn down here.